Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 87 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 150 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 151 and question 152. Question 151. You create an Azure storage account. You plan to add 10 blob containers to storage account. For one of the containers, you need to use different key to encrypt data at rest. What should you do before you create the container? Option A. Generate a shared access signature. Shared access signature is used to secure delegated access to resources. So it is related to access and it is not related to encryption of the data. Therefore, this is not the correct one. Option B, modify the minimum TLS version. Minimum TLS version only allows HTTP connections from visitors that supports the selected TLS protocol version or the newer one. Therefore, it has nothing to do with the encryption. Option C, rotate the access keys. These keys can be used to authorize access to data in storage account via shared key authorization or via shared access signature tokens that are signed with the shared key. So it is again related to access, not related to encryption. Therefore, this will not be the correct one. Option D, create an encryption scope. This is the correct answer for this question. But let's understand the encryption scope concept on learn.microsoft.com. We are on the encryption scopes for blob storage page. Encryption scope enables you to manage encryption with a key that is scoped to a container or individual blob. You can use encryption scopes to create secure boundaries between data that reside in the same storage account but belongs to different customer. Let's scroll down. How encryption scope works. By default, storage account is encrypted with a key that is scoped to the entire storage account. When you define an encryption scope, you specify a key that may be scoped to a container or individual blob. When the encryption scope is applied to a blob, the blob is encrypted with that key. When the encryption scope is applied to a container, it serves as the default scope for blobs in that container, so that all blobs that are uploaded to that container may be encrypted with the same key. The container can be configured to enforce the default encryption scope for all blobs in the container or to permit an individual blob to be uploaded to the container with encryption scope other than the default. Let's go back to question. Therefore, we can define scope of encryption for one of the container and it would have a different key to encrypt data. So option D, create an encryption scope, is the correct answer. Let's go to next question. Question 152. You have an Azure subscription. The subscription contains a storage account named Storage 1 that has the lifecycle management rules shown in the following table. The first rule, Rule 1 is applied on container 1 and the rule will trigger after 3 days from the last modification and it will move the blob to archive storage. Rule 2 will apply on everything and it will trigger after 5 days and it will move the blob to cool storage. Rule 3 will apply on container 2. It will trigger after 10 days and it will delete the blob in container 2. Rule 4 will trigger after 15 days and it will apply on container 2 and it will move to archive storage. But if you notice that on container 2, after 10 days, the blob will anyway be deleted. The rule 4 will not trigger anytime and rule 3 will trigger only. On June 1st, you store two blobs in storage 1 shown in following table. So first blob is file 1, which is going to container 1 and hot access tier. And file 2 is going to container 2 in hot access tier. Let's see what the questions are. So first statement, on June 6th, file 1 will be stored in cool access tier, yes or no? File 1 is stored in container 1, therefore rule 1 will be applicable to it, and after 3 days from the 1st of June, it will be moved to archive storage. Therefore, it won't be in the cool access tier, and answer would be no for this statement. Statement 2, on June 1st, file 2 will be stored in cool access tier. File 2 is the member of container 2, and on the container 2, rule 3 is applied, and rule 2 will be applied as it is open and applicable to everyone. Therefore, on the June 1st, it is added to hot access tier and it would remain to hot access tier as any of the rule won't be triggered by then. So, answer would be no. Statement 3. On June 16th, file 2 will be stored in archive access tier. File 2 is the member of container 2 and after 10 days, it will be deleted from the container 2 as the rule 3 will be triggered by then. Therefore, it won't be available to move to archive access. Therefore, answer for this statement would be no as well. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.